Welcome back, guys, to the Westin Smith channel, man. Today's episode is sponsored by the Googan Squad. We caught a lot of our fish on things like the Googan Squad Zinger spinnerbait. We also caught some goodies on their Googan baits, man. It was a great day of fishing. We end at the shop, man, taking our boat in to go get some upgrades. I think you guys are really, really gonna dig this one. Coming from a channel that is providing you one upload per day during quarantine, man. Probably one of the few fishing channels you will get that anywhere, and we really appreciate all the support and the new subscribers jumping on. Let's start this one off with me not really knowing how to fish. Enjoy.
Hold on. No, I don't.
I do!
What's up, y'all? Welcome back. We are strapped today, baby. We're hitting some exclusive ponds with our buddy Torrance. He actually got us the invite and the hookup on a little juicy zone out here. I wanted to showcase this Yakima Topwater roof rack real fast, though, before we get into today's festivities, because we've got like 7 combos up here. We don't use it all the time, but it holds up to 8. And I've got the 8-footer in here, guys, the 8-foot rod. So basically, take a peek inside of that thing right there. Yeah, it's got all the toys, man. Keeps the cabin free and clear. It keeps all your rods out of your leg space. No treble hooks in your pants that you gotta untangle when you get to the spot. Nice and tidy, ready to go. Let's go ahead and get to the water.
All right, we're out here, man. First couple casts. This is a huge pond. Torrance is way on the other side. I'm gonna meet up with him in a second, but since I walked down the wrong direction, I'm gonna wear this little corner out real fast. Super muddy. Chocolate milk today, boys. Chatterbait is getting worked. I need some extra vibration in the water. I'm choosing the shad color, something that stands out a little bit. Black and blue would work just as good or better or worse. It depends on who you are. I think throw whatever you're confident in. Here's a little action. You guys see that getting stirred up right in front of us? Maybe there's some bass creeping. Turtles are right here chilling. It's gonna be a good day. Let's get to work. Westin.
Justice.
Nice to meet you, man.
Great to meet you.
I hope they hungry for chatterbait. But the Texas rig's working out good, huh? No. That's a big, dude. Gotta be.
Is it big?
Is that a bass? All right. Torrance getting hooked up right off the bat. No way.
I choked it. That was a good fish, bro.
Oh my God. Rod bend, I thought it was a 10. Well, I might need to be throwing the bottom stuff. That was the Texas rig, right?
Yeah.
And then Justice just caught one on a bandito bug. You said it. It looked like you questioned it. Like maybe I'm just in the dirt in a log. If I don't get one on the chatterbait quick, I'm going straight to the Texas rig. I'm still contemplating tying on that spinnerbait because this swim jig isn't going to do us any good.
Torrance is putting us to shame, man. He's on again over here. I'm just trying to make a cast. You were right about the corner spot.
What's that, 2 and 2 minutes?
All right. He's a little guy, but he's something, man.
Yee.
Shoo-wee. Look how freaking pale they are, though. It's crazy.
Blending in with that muddy water.
Right?
Switching things up to a spinnerbait for a second. See if that thing will work. Justice and Torrance are on. That was almost a double up. Justice just let his go. No way. My gosh, dude. Texas rigs are killing it. I'm just hoping that... and something's eating out there. I'm hoping with this spinnerbait we can upsize a little bit, but it's a matter of time until just even the crawls and creatures smoke a big one. There we go, right at the bank. There we go, spinnerbait. Yeah. Spinnerbait, got him. First one on a moving bait today, guys. Heck yes. And let me show you how I dress this thing up. That's what I'm talking about. Little pale bass. Chunkers, though, they're fat in here. When we get a big one, it's going to be like plump, I bet. It's just going to be like a massive fish. I got a fluke on here, ice white, salty super fluke. I just chopped off a little bit of the nose, put it on the back of that Zinger spinnerbait. This is a 3/8 ounce, and it's got a gold and silver Colorado and willow blade. Just a lot of standout color right here going on. A little bit of chartreuse on the top. This isn't the solid white one. That skirt's got a little bit of that yellow. Doing the dirty work. Let's get him back in the water, man. Pumped on the first fish. See you, bud.
I thought I got stuck in the grass, dude. He bit like right there on the edge. All right, justice on again. What is going on? It's a slay fest.
That's what we talking about.
Oh, yeah.
Getting him. What are we throwing?
Black and blue bandito.
Too easy, man. Like clockwork. Sick. Plurk. Hold on. No, I don't. I do! I don't know! Dude, did you see that reaction? I'm like, I think.
Oh, you see it.
I'm like, is my line moving?
You were in the water and
the
claw was already bent.
It was already. So, guys, it's a little windy. For y'all that don't know, I was like, maybe I just got caught on something right off the bat. And you want to just kind of relax and leave your rod still. That way you can kind of feel out what's going on. Well, as soon as I saw the line swimming and was about to set the hook, he comes out of the water. That was that was a fun one. Ow. Dude, getting it done on the zinger. Yes. All right, that was retarded. Well, maybe I'm retarded. We'll get you back in the water, bud. Dang, flying off. Dude. There we go. All right, there we go. Nice. Biggest one of the day for me on the spinnerbait. Yee-hoo! Come here. There we go.
Gotcha, fish on, except this isn't good because I think it might be a good fish. There's a snake. Get out of the grass. Get up here, get up here. Whew. Dang, good fish. Huh. First chunk, thank goodness.
Biggest one of the day.
It was sketchy. It was really sketchy because I was up high and I couldn't tell how big he was. There was a snake right in front of me on the water. So I'm like, dude, how am I gonna do this? I was like, if it's big enough, I don't know how I'm gonna get this out. So not a bad guy. Look how fat these guys are. I'm gonna go ahead and put him on the scale for why not. Keep him dunked in the water. Chaotic first catch, what the heck? I imagine it's gonna say 288.
That's what you bet.
Oh, look.
All right.
A little over three.
Yes.
I broke the three.
She's been on these like 2 3/4 for weeks now. It's so funny. She hasn't been, I don't know what the deal has been, but anyways.
I don't even know.
All right, y'all, man, we are all getting on some fish. We have regrouped and we're going to hit the little creek system on the back half of this place. So we'll catch you guys right over there. A little change in scenery back here. Get that out of them mud boots. Skirt. We have pulled up, ladies and gents. Look at that muddy oasis. I don't know, that dam is sounding pretty good.
They turned off in the creek today, boys. I wonder if there's anything in here. I don't think there's any fish in it. Hey, I was gonna try that spot.
Oh!
They gotcha. Nope, in the grass.
I was about to say.
It's a snake. Yeah, that scared me.
Oh, nice one. ant pile like crazy. Check yourself for ants. That was funny. Oh, right in the grass. Right in the grass. Wow. Gotcha. Ah. Gotcha. Get out of there. Get out. Come on. No, holy moly. Ah, good lord.
Our battle wound. All right, this might be our last one of the day. Not a bad one. This was actually on that Texas rigged black and blue crack and crawl. Kind of been fighting with this guy for I think a few casts now. He finally committed and grabbed it, set the hook. After that whole fiasco of me getting caught in the grass, stepping on a snake. Oh my god, I don't know if y'all even caught any of that, but not bad. Look, he's got a bloody tail. I wonder if they're still kind of in the spawn. All right, so we're gonna get him back in the water, but this, like I said, might be the last one of the day just because we're about to go pick up the boat and take it to the shop to drop it off to be able to get our new additions added onto it. So stay tuned and see what's in store.
Yeah, so she tripped out. He like darted down there. Oh, all right, come on up. Oh God, that's, oh, that was like a four. That was like a four, that one was bigger. That one was fat. Woo! That's the one that's back in that corner I almost caught earlier. Yeah, that don't rub your fluorocarbon against metal, guys. That was a stupid move.
All right, y'all, and on that note, we are gonna take off, get over to Fun and Sun and get these upgrades done on the boat. But Devin is taking off her shoes because this is what we've got to walk across to get to the car much faster than the alternative route. First, quick pit stop. All right, back at the house, gonna enjoy the canes before we head out. We let the dogs out. We gotta go pick up the boat from storage. So, a couple more things to do. We'll catch you guys at the shop. All right, man, pulling up to Fun and Sun. Let's get inside this place and see what we can't purchase for the young RT-188 Peaster. But we were thinking maybe two USBs, like right here. All right, guys, that is that. We are getting the old Ranger hooked up. And by the way, we got a name, right? I don't even know. It's like, Red Ranger. We could call her Social Distancing, the SS Social Distance. What do you guys think is right? Anyways, I don't know if we should tell you what we're getting or not. I will tell you this, we're upgrading the trolling motor and we're doing a few more things, man. So y'all take your guesses. Some of you probably already know based on what we put out, but we might do a little bit of fishing later. We might wrap things up. Anyways, we'll keep you posted. Stay tuned. What's up, guys? Good evening. It is literally like 8 p.m. I'm getting out with the Dylan Hunter. We're gonna try and hit some topwater over here at a spot that gets fished so often. But guess what? It looks like the banks are not getting hit too hard tonight. The water is up, man. We just had a lot of recent rain and we're thinking maybe these bass are pushing up, chasing some bait. And guess what? We are ready to throw some frogs in there, see if we can't get bit. So it's gonna be a lot of fun. You guys go ahead and get prepared.
All right, man, here's the situation. Sun's setting. I just got the bag on me with the scale and yeah, the pliers, line cutter, in case I need to retie. I brought the swim bait down here, so if I need to retie because I get a bite on that, I might decide to throw him last minute. We'll see what happens, man. I brought the walking frog, not the popping frog. I'm tending to like these a lot more, you guys. I like to trim the legs. That way you can get that walk a little easier. And yeah, that's just about it. Let's see if we can't get some bass, man. Adele is already here working the banks. I think I've seen you here, right?
Yeah.
What's up, man? How you been?
Good.
Getting on any tonight?
Not yet. There's one over there.
That's what Adele said you had mentioned, right? Yeah, that's dope. Well, we're trying to find him, man. I'm thinking maybe where there's less light over here, we might get started early. I'm curious. See what happens. We're going for the little froggy blow ups. You know the deal. Dude, it's packed tonight. Good to see you, man. Okay, I see him now. Dude, trade days in McKinney was packed.
I saw that on your story.
Like just business as usual. Dude, like a 3-pounder, 2-pounder. Yeah, they're just locked up shallow. He just went right here. I'm wondering if he's gonna peek back out. All right, time to grab something else, y'all. Frog ain't doing it. I have no doubts you're gonna get one on the frog, but if it's closing in on 9 o'clock and I got a lot more editing to do on this one, it might be a late nighter.
All right, y'all, top water was a no-go, but thank you so much for tuning in for today's one-a-day video. The boat is getting some awesome stuff done to it, and let me tell you what, we have been getting hit up out of the blue by some amazing companies, man, offering us some awesome products. Be looking out, dudes. If you're not subscribed, hit that button real quick. Hit all notifications, because some of y'all don't get notified on every video. Well, all you gotta do is check back every day, I guess. Anyways, we got a lot of new goodies, new toys, man, getting sent to us, and I cannot wait for you guys to see all that is in store on the channel. We'll catch y'all tomorrow, man. Peace.